In your book, I think 2016, you gave a warning to someone, and it is very important that we look at it. You know, it has been something that is now recurring now. You know, that is the person of the entrepreneur himself. I'm looking for his name in the book here, and the prediction appears to almost come to pass. That's on page 196 of prediction 2016. There are other predictions on him, but Statue Raymond Dupuisi, he said you need to quit politics totally. That's number one. Then shun free ladies and desist from sleeping with wives or friends and that of well wishers. That's like a warning, sir, to this eminent Nigeria, as stated in this book.
Who made him eminent?
No, he's an eminent Nigeria because he had first class in marine engineering from.
But after the
Portland,
first class,
Portland.
He stole money from Abiola himself and Yadua.
No. He was manager of Ocean Ocean View.
My brother, leave eminent out of it.
Yes,
when the politicians want to steal, yes, they will sell all protocol observe. Yes, what are the protocols?
Now saying he's an eminent Nigerian because he had first class in marine engineering from Holland.
Was he not the one that used stone to break his car in order to steal money?
Maybe the attack him during the election, sir.
He attacked himself.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Don't call anybody eminent.
Sorry, sir, because you now said in this book that you wrote Peter to pay Paul to establish AIT.
Uh-huh.
By 2035, AIT will be owned by the government.
Yes.
Sean pride and lying.
Uh-huh.
Now, sir, there are other warnings in other prediction, but this is most prominent. You warned him also in prediction 2017.
You can prediction. Show it to the people.
Yeah, prediction 2017 is also there. It's also there here in prediction 2017. There's a warning. On page 221 of 2017, you said, pray for your family members, especially those in Detroit. Pray not to bury your staff and loved ones. Pray not to be jailed for looting taxpayers' money. Quit politics in totality. Reconcile and live in peace with people around you. Then you said, pray against illness that can take you out of the country in 2020.
And come back dead.
Yes, and come back dead, yeah. Then shun free ladies and act of sleeping with widows. Pray for good health. Don't eat porridge and change your domestic staffs. Be careful of what you make people carry you from Abuja to your village. Go back to your town and meet the youth elders to discuss the way forward of the place. Pray to God for you not to die in sin. Don't add more wives and concubines. Denounce all cult you belong. Build schools and orphanages. And don't be diplomatic. That's 2017. And even in, I think in 2015, he also had a wonderful message. You know, there are other, the messages have been coming, and there are a lot of them. Okay, let's come to 2018. In 2018, there's also a warning. I think it was organizational I gave here.
Okay.
Yeah. So, sir, recently his station was attacked, and it was proscribed by the government, by the Nigerian Broadcasting Corporation, because they said there was some contents that were not too very friendly with the presidency and not friendly with the polity, that were hitting the polity.
Hate speech?
Yeah, like hate speech and incisive comments on the TV station, and they closed it down until when the courts now said they should open it again, that they should open it until the case is settled, the case has been in court. So within 24 hours, the station is open again. What advice do you have for him, and what do you think is happening? Is it something that's, like you said in your book in 2016, that government will take over the station? Because out of like 20 outlets now, 20 stations across Nigeria, Sierra Leone, and Liberia and some other country, they have reduced to like 4 now. So what is really happening? And we're also having strange report that staff are being on salary, some are up to 2 years, some 1 year plus, some even going to 3 years, some are dead, still fighting for their money from the grave and all that. and all sort of sordid news.
Do you meet any one of them fighting from the grave?
No, they said some are fighting. They were fighting when they died while fighting.
Ah, Benga.
We just want to know the position.
People still fighting from the grave.
Yeah. They didn't pay them their salary, sir. That's what they said.
When you look at Ecclesiastes 5, from verse 6, no, 1 to 10, only enjoy the only wife you marry in your lifetime. Because there is no anything you can do in the graveyard. Only if you are your buyer, you can't find it by you. Ni tori pe ko se ete abi imo abi ija ni sare ibi to nlo to ma ti le ti le ko mo de ki yen that's all. Because there's an agreement between the creator and the soil oni fun idi eyi ni igbeyin oni a o fi eruku fun eruku then iyepe fun kini iyepe fun iyepe when you start something on a fraudulent way. Dr. Pesi has not been a clean person from the beginning. But he was only trying to tell people that he's a good person. He goes around sleeping with people's wife, this and that. He likes going to the widow house and even forgotten his slippers and sometimes, you see. Oh my God. I could remember 2001 or 2002? I have a radio program there. They were asking me questions about Dr. Pesi. One of the prominent people that set up, so I said, Dr. Pesi is not a prominent person. No. He robbed Peter to pay Paul. He was aspiring to be a great person, but his background was not good. And when the foundation is bad, there's nothing the righteous can do. And that's what we're still seeing. And when you look at Lazarus, you know Lazarus is still alive.
Yes, sir.
You know my brother founded Lazarus.
The man from the Okebo, sir.
Yes, now Fajr Miracle. He's still there. Now you know the Arewa gave my brother, the accountant from Idori. The Arewa Consortium Forum gave him an auditing. Mm. But before he goes to the house, the Arewa people gave him two Mercedes. Mm. He said, is that an accountant to work?
That's
like Yeah, he said, please. Take your Mercedes and take your contract. I don't want it because I want to make heaven. Yeah. And I have a sleepless night on my certificate. So I wouldn't want any Dick and Harry to just come and just knock it away from me. Yeah. My brother, the worst is still in the front.
What do you mean, sir?
Do you know who owns the place? You know the place has been going from hand to everywhere. They don't do anything meaningful there. He hide on that secondo. Maybe he shouting, maybe when the other man will dash him money again. That's Atiku. They were all running towards Atiku. Maybe he can win in a fraudulent way so that they can bounce back and pay salaries. He's hiding money outside. He's not sincere to his staff. You know what I'm saying?
You mean High Chief Raymond Al?
Yeah, he's not a straightforward person. You can be a graduate. Even Judas Iscariot was so smart. You know, he never come directly to Jesus Christ. He said, whoever I kiss. That's Luke 22 from verse 1 to 5. Then that was why Jesus Christ replied them in the book of Luke 22 from verse 45 to 55. He said, why do you come with cordial and even machete to come and what? To come and arrest me. I will follow you honorably. I'm a humble person. And Jesus proved it to them. And those that killed Jesus Christ on Friday, they regretted on Sunday. Because that was another glorious Sunday. If you are doing something, no any MD in the bank? Is it all these people? Like Tayo Adeyinoku, the late one.
Okay, sir.
Then Fola Adeola. And then Sheikh Wagbaji, you know how they play their game? You know how they play their game? Tie up block Fola Adeola out. Then Sheikh Wagbaji was on what? Was a lice man.
Yes, sir.
Then when the die was cast, then Sheikh Wagbaji, who started with 2 million, now came to the limelight and brought all these people in and then sacked all of them. And these people are still working. If you wanted to be great in Nigeria, go and set up a bank. That was why Saraki wanted to die about having a bank. because you can use your bank to what, to empower anybody. You remember what happened in Akin Bola's issue?
Yes, sir.
When the man who helped him to, when the two of them who founded the bank, with that one coming, drawing money, then one day, they just gave him paper.
Yes,
Akin Bola gave him a paper that you've drawn all your share. You see? And these are the people we call good people.
Great people, sir.
They are not great people. They are fraudulent. Mm. Look at Sobomi Balogun and the rest of people. Do you know Akin Bola worked with Sobomi? But he knew when they were playing coup against Akin Bola, he was aware. It was the bank they were using to cheat everybody in this country. Bank is a useless thing in this country. Even the man in the CBN now, you see what will happen to him. They have stolen a lot of money during Goodluck regime and everything. But you say you still see good in him. That means Buhari has run out of ideas about bank. These are crook people. Even as the money they removed to set up, to buy a jet for themselves. Yeah. So, but where are we going? 2 Samuel 14:14. He said, we should remember that one day we are going to drop dead. Ezekiel 14:14. Then Isaiah 49, Psalm 49. Then Isaiah 43. Mm-hmm. Isaiah 40 and 41. You know, all these people will still die one day and leave all this thing down. 1 Timothy 3, 1 Timothy 4 and 5. Then 2 Timothy 6. Then 1 Corinthians 2 and 3. Is there another foundation we cannot lay? Why are people so deceitful? Nigerians are four. They like cutting corners. They like what? Cutting corners. Yes. About this man, we should not bother. What happened to Saraki will still happen to him. You know Saraki was a senator.
Yes,
was he collecting a retiree money in what? In Otoge State. But when the people stood up, they said Otoge, and really, it was Otoge.
Hmm.
So the time will come where we'll be to be Otoge for all these people. You know, they don't want Buhari to come back again.
Yes, sir.
You see a lot of money he gave to them, they said it was a dash.
Hmm.
Do you remember the man who had been helping them to siphon money during the time of Alamasia? Tayo Ayeni.
Hmm.
These are the bank people.
Very strategic banker.
Take money and go to everywhere and buy a house in Georgia. Buy a house in Texas, then go out with a fleet of cars and everything, buying first class ticket, 2 million, 3 million for girlfriends. Then you see, Nigerians are fond of using fake life. When this millionaire took a girl to the hotel, stayed there for 1 week, and when the lady is leaving, he left the place with Samsung 8. Then they gave him 500,000. Does that lady have a job? He was selling, he was using the factory they put in between his two legs to make money. He can't pay tax clearance. You were here when Dr. Percy collected the wife of Colectosi from that young man. He put that lady in a permanent night so that he can be seeing Tosi all the time. And Tosi wanted to marry a chief. And you will see what will happen to Tosi if they close the place. Eventually, they lost the place. They will still close the place down. Because a good man, a good businessman, will not be partisan. He need to be neutral. But he has put the PDP on his head. You know, the PDP that is financing the place for so long. Just like Obasanjo Investment, who is using Nigerian money to pay his staff. Nigerians are fond of cutting corners. Nigerians are fond of what? Fake life. All the money in the hand of Dangote. How many companies has Dangote worked before he became a millionaire? How many companies has Mike Adenuga worked? He float a bank. That's what they will first do. Then after that bank, then they can do and undo. They can empower a conductor. They can even empower a war gecko. Because the money, another people's money not there. Then when they wanted to put you into trouble, they said, the ATM machine is down. And then... Oh my God! What we are seeing is not—it's not strange. The Lord has predicted everything through me, and thank God, is everything in the book.
Yes, sir.
These are the books. Books. These are the books.
Yes, sir.
These are the books. Then it was in this
book. Yes, sir.
Akechi will sleep and never woke up.
Yes, sir.
You remember?
Yeah.
Then Alamazia will lose his son.
Yes, sir.
And eventually, die of high blood pressure.
Hmm.
So thank God that we're having everything in black and white.
Documented.
Even after my death, it's a legacy. It depends, because rather for me to marry two wives or three concubines, I better be writing book for the people coming behind me. They will know that a prophet has passed through this place.
So, sir, what can we now do to help the chief to get out of this trouble? Because in one of your books, you said you go to the...
They don't need help. They want chief to decide politics.
Okay, sir.
But he's not obeying the law, what the law asked him to do. Why do you want them to be in politics throughout your whole lifetime? Even by the end of this year, Tinubu is supposed to have resigned from politics. When you look at what is in Lagos State now, Daga is very close to the neck of Tinubu. You know I'm sad it's from Fashola's carcass. You know that? Then what about the other man? Sanwo-Olu. He's the same thing. They have a carcass. Then when you look at his speaker in the state, what's the name of the speaker of Lagos State now? He's a terrible crook. He's even worse than the one Ejibo King that committed suicide the other day on Petrola on Bunkri.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You know, he built his...
Yes.
Yeah, he was taking the two truck every night.
Yeah, the lawyer now ran away.
Yeah. So automatically, these people are cutting corners. They are not straightforward. Oh, roti or room. Come for home, meji. Jeun kia. Jeun soke, jeun siku. About 4, about 50, about 2,000 kosebe. The Ondo State Governor.
No, sir. The Boko sebe.
She was a chill American. To my the door, walk. Oh, my uncle, the bad jeju. To the yak, bado. Ah, wala ti lere. Harolo biwa.